Salut, c'est Jean-Paul Sartre. Laissez un message et je vous rappellerai.
Hey, John, it's me, Chris. I hope you don't mind that I'm going to use your criticism of ethical theories in Existentialism is a Humanism in my parody of the Rockford Files. Also, could I borrow 20 francs? Following passages are from Sartre's lecture, Existentialism is a Humanism. As an example by which you may the better understand the state of abandonment, I will refer you to the case of a pupil of mine who sought me out in the following circumstances. His father was quarreling with his mother and was also inclined to be a collaborator with the Nazis. His elder brother had been killed in the German offensive by the Nazis, and this young man, with a sentiment somewhat primitive but generous, burned to avenge his brother's death. His mother was living alone with him, deeply afflicted by the semi-treason of his father and by the death of her eldest son, and her one consolation was in this young man. But he, at this moment, had the choice between going to England to join the Free French forces or staying near his mother and helping her to live. He fully realized that this woman lived only for him and that his disappearance, or perhaps his death, would plunge her into despair. He also realized that concretely and in fact, every action he performed on his mother's behalf would be sure of effect in the sense of aiding her to live, whereas anything he did in order to go and fight would be an ambiguous action which might vanish like water into sand and serve no purpose. For instance, to set out for England, he would have to wait indefinitely in a Spanish camp on the way through Spain, or arriving in England or in Algiers, he might be put into an office to fill forms. See, he was trying to decide between two kinds of morality. On the one side, a morality of sympathy, of personal devotion, staying with the mother, and on the other side, a morality of wider scope, but of more debatable validity. He had to choose between the two. What could help him to choose? Could the Christian doctrine? No. Christian doctrine says, act with charity, love your neighbor, deny yourself for others, choose the way which is hardest, and so forth. But which is the harder road? To whom does one owe the more brotherly love? The patriot or the mother? Which is the more useful aim, the general one of fighting in and for the whole community, or the precise aim of helping one particular person to live? Who can give an answer to that a priori? No one, nor is it given in any ethical scripture. The Kantian ethic says, never regard another as a means, but always as an end. Very well, if I remain with my mother, I shall be regarding her as the end and not as a means. But by the same token, I'm in danger of treating as a means those who are fighting on my behalf. And the converse is also true, that if I go to the aid of the combatants, I shall be treating them as the end at the risk of treating my mother as a means.